All right, ladies and gentlemen, 11 years later. Holy crap, what a journey it's been. From 2010 to 2021, today's October 5th, 2021. Today is the premiere of Alan Wake Remastered. Holy crap. Did I ever think that I'd be playing Alan Wake Remastered? No, I didn't know they would ever make Alan Wake Remastered. Back in the day, I thought if Alan Wake was popular enough, they would make a series of games. They didn't. What they did is they did two DLCs, and then they did a spinoff later on called American Nightmare. That kind of ended the story, but not really. So, anyway. I'm excited to be replaying this game after 11 freaking years. I am. It's one of the games that actually back in the day... profile initializing. Look at that. Back in the day, it actually put me on the map as a YouTuber. Because the way I covered it with a camera allowed me to continue recording even when my power went out, which was crazy. My power went out during the premiere of, like, a spooky-ass game like Alan Wake. It was pretty neat. Now, from what I'm going to understand, this game actually comes with the DLCs as well. From what I'm going to understand, I don't know how to access them. We're going to have subtitles enabled. Video commentary? No, but I want subtitles. By the way, we're going to up the brightness slightly. Like that. This game has a licensed soundtrack. There are songs in this game made by real bands, but that's okay. For this game, since the music is so, I would feel it's a part of the game. I would feel like it would actually be a disservice to play Alan Wake again and not have the music be a part of it. So in this case, I'm going to say this up front as I play Alan Wake Remastered, okay? Please, guys, if you like this playthrough, if you're enjoying the fact that I'm playing this game again after 11 years and coming back to it with my new style of content creation and commentary, please support the playthrough in other means than ad revenue on YouTube. I guarantee you these videos on YouTube are all going to get claimed because of the licensed soundtrack, but I don't want to ruin the true experience of this game, especially for those of who have never seen the original playthrough. I want you to hear the music. I want to hear the music again, but likely I'm going to make no money on these videos on YouTube because of that. So please, if you're watching on demand on YouTube, please support the playthrough in other means. You can check the descriptions of the videos for all different ways that you can contribute. Please consider it, okay? Okay. Without further ado, we're going to get started. Derek says, I was watching your Alan Wake weekend preview last night. I love the Thriller remix. Snowstar says, Alan Wake was the first playthrough I saw of yours. Hyped to see you play it again. Super Backhat says, yes, the band is called Poets of the Fall, who did most of the songs for the game. That's correct. Now, everything here is good. We're going to go new game, normal difficulty. Here we go.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end.
That's why a lot of horror movies and games have no true explanations for what's going on. La la la.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream.
I had a dream that I would be stuck in a nightmare.
Nightmare pattern. I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
God damn!
I seen the hitchhiker too late.
Oh my god. Fucking splatted, dude. I know what you did last fall's autumn before the day that the leaves fell off of the trees.
I was convinced they put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Damn. He's gone. Did he hit him or not? Oh my god.
Suddenly, his body was gone.
Episode 1, Nightmare.
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
So what's now funny is now the real audio of the game just started playing, and it sounds amazing. Like, now the audio sounds great. The audio of the cutscene kind of sounded washed out, because likely it's the original audio from 11 years ago. But now the audio has kicked up, and now it's like spooky surround sound I can hear in the headphones, which is really nice. Keep in mind, back in the day, I didn't wear headphones. It was open in my condo in Connecticut. I used to have this surround sound system in the room. It sounded great for me, but for the camera, it sounded very echoey and bad. So now it's actually going to have some pretty good direct capture audio and everything. The visuals, look at this. Look how funny this is behind you. The tunnel is walled up behind you. Oh, by the way, some shout-outs. Team Ico Gamer with a whopping $50 tip. He says, here's to a fun playthrough. Let's go. Thank you so much, Team Ico Gamer. Very generous tip to start off here. Let's get that up on the leaderboard. So up to $90 in tips. And then I received a $4.20 tip from Moonwalkman, who says, asking you shall receive. Have fun with Alan Wake. I love this game, and I love your Alan Wake Thriller song. Awesome. We actually played that right before I started playing this on stream today. If you haven't seen it, and you're interested in seeing my review of this game from 11 years ago, as well as the Thriller song that I made, just search for The Hateful Truth, Alan Wake, on YouTube, and you will find it. That is my review of the game from 11 years ago. Okay, let's get these glasses on, and then let's see how this game is different in the remastered version from the original. So, look at the camera. Ah! Reverse your controls for looking up and down? No. You can change camera settings in the menu options screen. Okay. Use left stick to walk. Hold down left bumper to sprint. Now, what's funny about this, if you take a look, these are, I believe, your books. You see it says Alan Wake? These are your books. You're a writer, and apparently the trunk of your car was full of your own books. I wonder if this is still true. Do writers go around the country still, like, on tour with like, trunkfuls of their own books to try to like, sell and sign?
I knew there was something waiting for me there.
Yeah, I know that, like, a lot of writers, they go around, like, trying to hawk their own stuff, so they bring books with them to sign from their trunks and stuff. I think what we should do is we should actually have this reversed and be on the bottom, because there's going to be stuff at the top of the screen, I believe. Just some things that are very different from the content style I used to do. No face cam, no talking with an interactive audience, no shout outs, no leaderboards, nothing, none of that back in the day, right? Things are very different today, so... Oh, examine the car.
The radiator had broken when I hit the hitchhiker. The car wasn't going anywhere.
I mean, you hit him at such maximum fucking velocity. It was tremendously amazing that the guy wasn't liquidized or liquefied as soon as you hit him. Drop hazard. Oh. Let's test that. Oh, shit. Oh, no!
I was in shock from the crash.
That was great. My feet. It's like Groundhog Day. He kills himself on the cliff. He goes right back to where he started. All right. Very nice. Okay. So you could definitely jump off the cliff or the drop hazard. All right. All right, you run with left bumper. There you go. Dude, the 60 frames are throwing me for a loop because the original game barely ran at 30. Like, the original game actually chugged along on the Xbox 360 and had some lot of issues with frame rate.
I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Rain Cove Point. Get to the lighthouse. The light effects are definitely a major part of the game. Get to the lighthouse. I love the music of this game, too. Nate the Great has just done a super chat and says, graphics looking good. Can you move the overlay to the top? It's blocking subtitles. Oh, shit, you're right. Man. It doesn't look like there's a good place for the overlay, right? Oh, man. If it, on the bottom, it blocks the subtitles. On the top, it blocks the meters and stuff. Hmm. What do you guys think? Bottom or top for the leaderboard? It's got to be one or the other. Did you like it top or bottom? My tips goal is wrong. You're right. You should say 100, and it says 50. Thank you. Fix that. Top again? All right. We'll put it back to the top. I didn't realize it was going to block the subtitles like that. And the narration is a humongous part of this game, as you guys will see. If you've never seen the original playthrough, you're in for a treat. The plot of this game is really good. Very, very mysterious, ongoing air of like confusion and mystery and suspense. And you have to pay attention to everything the narrator says because it actually factors into the plot. So, welcome to Night Springs. Population 2,589. I wonder if I would have been able to read that on the Xbox 360. But as you can see, the bridge is out, but look what we've got over here.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
A thermos. Collectible thermoses picked up 1 of 100. Yes. So literally you're picking up an actual thermos like I have right here. This is what you're picking up as collectibles during the course of the game. And there's a freaking 100 of them. 100. Okay. Derek says, I was watching your Alan Wake Collector's Edition unboxing May 18th, 2010. Yeah. Oddly enough, this game, you would think it came out in October, right? No, it came out in May of 2010. So now I'm playing it in October of 2021. Definitely a better time of the year for it. Is that a can? It's a six pack. There's a six pack, an unopened six pack of beer on the floor right there. Green Cove Point Lighthouse hiking trail. If you just clobbered some poor guy in the street, you probably should have drinking a six pack. Take the edge off. Oh boy, what was that? Uh-oh. He's robbing your car. Oh shit.
You don't recognize me, do you, Ryder?
You
think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff?
Oh, fuck. Whoa.
You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer.
Oh, look, there's a QR. Whoa, there's a QR code. Now, there weren't QR codes back in the day, right? I wonder if you take a picture of this QR code, if it takes you to something interesting. I'm going to take a picture of it just to have it for later. Yeah, look, open YouTube and Safari. It's actually opening something. Vision 01 posted 4 months ago. It's playing. Wow, it's playing a new cutscene that's not from the original game on my phone right now. What the hell? Wow.
Chris, use that knowledge to rewrite my reality.
Whoa, that's pretty neat. It's Alan Wake. He's typing and he's talking. I mean, I don't know. This is probably going to be a problem. If you play it, you probably get in trouble. But if you guys could scan that QR code, you're going to want to scan it and watch this extra cutscene. They added extra cutscenes to the game on YouTube. That's interesting. Oh, I never expected they were going to do that. Huh. Neat. Okay. Rob on Wheels has sent me $4.20. And one of my best friends is an author. She carries her books around. Oh, yeah. So it's still a thing. Even though it's a kind of a stereotypical thing, they still do that, huh? They carry around with their books to sell and to sign. All right. So look, missing. That's you. Missing. Have you seen this man? Call this number. Interesting. That's pretty neat that they put QR codes in the game. I wonder what other things they'll lead to. All right. Whoa, look at the fog. Press A to jump. Checkpoint reached.
You missed your deadline.
Ha ha. I think it's B. Left bumper. Oh no. Left bumper, left stick to dodge. Ow, that didn't work. There you go.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
Ah. Okay. Ah, look, now the visual effects disappeared. Oh, the new model self-opening gates. Those are my favorites, actually. Spawn Killer took me $2. Says those are the scripts from his book. Is that what the cutscenes are? Scripts from the book? You guys will see as we play further in. Cheb just did a super chat and he said, we love you in Yorkshire, England, Phil. Keep keeping on, lad. Thank you, Cheb. Let's get that on the leaderboard. Thank you all for the nice support. 11 years later, I really appreciate that I still have people coming out and supporting my stuff, and the fact that I get to re-experience a game from 11 years ago is pretty sweet, man. Alright, checkpoint reached. The dodge. There it is. That's dodging right there.
To die by the hands of your own creation.
Sounds like this guy's got a frog in his throat. He's gonna clear his throat out. Oh, shit. We got the sprint. He's coming for me. Or not. He's not following me anymore. Look. Whoa, hiking trail. The whole place is coming down. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Anything over here? Yo, it's so dark. You see anything over here? Oh, crap. Stuck. Oh, no! He got sucked. Alan got sucked. Poor guy.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Oh, really? Derek says there were QR codes in the game in 2010 as well. Obviously, they're not the same as these, because these lead to things on YouTube that were only posted a few months ago. Run! I guess I'm out of stamina, because he won't run. The fog moving is pretty crazy. The effect of the fog is neat. Thank you, Mario Brothers, for renewing your membership to the channel. I appreciate that. Oh, shit. Holy crap. Oh, you're gonna shoot that fucking storm with a gun?
Inside there.
Oh no!
Stop! No! Damn it, die! No! No!
Uh-oh! He asked him a question. Brutal murder. Now it's your turn, wakey boy.
No way out.
Oh, look at the TV with an eyeball. Die, 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 you're gonna die now. Tom the Poet? Ha ha, everywhere you look, there's an eyeball. Woo!
The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
Die, 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 it's time to die now. How do I get out? Whoa.
Follow the light.
Ugh.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Go to the safe haven of the light. Yes. Stay in the safe haven until you are up.
Well done.
Until you're safe again.
I have something important to tell you. It goes like this.
Okay, God.
But I did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No. No. Stupid.
Dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
So far, the graphics are pretty good, and the surround sounds excellent. Like, I'm hearing his voice in the direction that he is. Like, that light, that's where I'm hearing him in my headphones. Nice. I like that surround sound. Checkpoint reached.
The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
All right, we got our flashlight.
Your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Ah, this sort of battery.
You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy.
Shoot his ass.
Take the gun.
Thank you, Cheb, for another super chat. I appreciate that.
Pick up the rope.
Now you'll die.
Six shots. Damn, he's a fucking Terminator.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare.
Thanks, God.
Terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Alright, so boosting the light with left trigger will blind enemies and burn the darkness away faster. I shot the cans. I don't think that did anything. How do you reload? I don't know how to reload. Oh shit. How do you reload? They never taught me how to reload. Yeah, how do I manually reload? Hold B, no. Y, no. Oh, was it X? It was X. Okay, and it says if you tap, it'll reload even faster. You saw that? Chris B says, what up? This is one of your best OG playthroughs. Excited for this one. Truth of the matter is, I don't remember a lot of the plot. I know the plot's good, but I don't remember a lot of the plot. It's been 11 years. Here we go. What the fuck? He fell. He fell off the edge. Is he still down there? Where'd he go? Oh shit! Oh man, he stuck up behind me. What a dickhead. Yeah, if you tap, okay, if you tap X, you reload even faster. Yeah, he came this way. He's like, you fucking bastard, you blinded me with the light, you dick. Fell off the edge. Yeah, these graphics are way better than they were 11 years ago. These graphics are, like, significantly better. Just the lighting effects and the fog effects and everything, like, it's, like, way more realistic. Wow. I actually like these. I like this. Goji Tanks just sent me $2 said, have a good stream. We need a hat. All right, so we're going to have a poll now for a hat on the stream. Thank you guys again for the support. Already at tier 2. Of our three-tiered tips goal. Oh my god. By the way, guys, so here's something cool. I'm going to set up the poll. My wife, for the very first time, is making a pot of homemade stew to celebrate the launch of Alan Wake Remastered. No, she just wanted to make stew. It smells so good. It's beef, high-grade beef, with carrots, golden potatoes, beef broth, some red wine, thyme, other seasonings. It's just, it smells amazing right now. She's making it right now, has to cook all day. So she's slow cooking it and like, oh my god, my house. Oh, I smell it right now, it smells so good and I gotta wait till like 4 o'clock to eat it. Son of a bitch, 3 more hours. Anyway, so, the digital, the camo, or the fake hair hats are your choices today because I do have to wear the headphones. That's absolutely correct, Barrel Shrice. It's nothing like a warm bowl of soup, especially now in the fall. She's slow cooking it. Oh, it's going to be so amazing. It's cool, a cool day today. Could I have that for dinner? Have some bread, dip it in? Oh my god, it's gonna be crazy good. I can't wait. Alright, let's continue. These graphics are so dramatically improved. So, we have open the box. Inside we find a flare gun ammo. And more flare gun ammo. We don't have... Oh, and the flare gun. So now you can change weapons with the D-pad. So the flare gun essentially is kind of like a powerful weapon that does like crazy damage. But you want to save that for like mini bosses, or if you're overwhelmed by a group of enemies, that's when you want to use the flare gun. Every other normal enemy, you want to just use the flashlight and the regular gun. But there will be situations where the flare gun will make more sense. Here we go. Found our second coffee thermos of the game. What a view. Okay. Enclave Soldiers says, for a second I thought you were playing Until Dawn. This is way before Until Dawn. This game was like 5-6 years before Until Dawn.
Just like...
Here we go. And yes, you can get headshots if you're very accurate. It's kind of hard in this game to get them, but you can get headshots. If you shoot them in the legs, they walk slower. Like, basically, the area of damage is very effective in the game, if I remember correctly. I'm out of batteries for the flashlight, which is not good. He fell. Yeah, I fell right off the edge. Damn, he fell all the way down there. He's dead. Didn't even have to shoot him. There's an Alan Wake ad right there on the building. Look at that. So, checkpoint reached. That's where they want me to go. Uh-oh.
I can keep this up
forever. Uh-oh. It's coming for me. Run, Alan, run.
He dodges flying cars. He knows his life's at stake. Ooh!
Oh god, he's got a bunion on his foot. He can't run anymore. He's tired. Look out. He's running in Reebok pumps, and he popped the air bag inside the pumps. So now he's limping. Oh fuck. Can't do anything with that. Oh shit. Run, run, run. Oh god, it's right behind me, isn't it? I gotta get inside. Woo! Knock, knock, motherfucker. Jehovah's Witnesses, open the door. We got the new issue of Watchtower for you. Uh-oh. How long is this game? I believe it's around 15 hours long, I want to say. Oh, boy.
Alan, wake up.
Shh, baby. Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
I can see you right now.
Handsome. We're here.
They dramatically improved these rendered cutscenes because in the original, the lips wouldn't sync properly in a lot of the cutscenes, and already it looks really good. It looks like they redid the cutscenes. Welcome to Bright Falls. So not Night Falls, Bright Falls. Night Falls was in his nightmare. The real place they're going is Bright Falls. It looks like the fake hair hat has won the poll, so I might as well get it. So Derek is asking an interesting question. He's saying, in the old days when I used to play games, hold on, because I want to pause to answer. In the old days when I used to play games, Especially a game like this, Alan Wake, where there was, like, a lot of light-dark contrast, right? Like, you're in the forest, it's dark as shit, you're using the flashlight, now you're using light-to-dark contrast. He says, back in the day, he used to notice a lot of issues with the lighting in my videos. Like, a flickering effect would happen. And it was very annoying and distracting, and he's wondering what caused that. It was actually the exposure settings of my camera. Any camera. That's not, you know, this is direct capture right now. Direct capture of the video from the game console. But if you're using a digital camera, cameras have exposure settings. Excuse me. And the exposure settings of a camera, when you're doing a lot of dark and then all of a sudden there's light in it, it basically creates that kind of weird exposure effect where there's a lot of flickering and stuff. So, yeah, basically that was the issue, is that back then, using a camera, a game like this looked absolutely terrible. I know my playthrough of Alan Wake looked bad. It was entertaining to watch because of my commentary, but it definitely looked bad. This playthrough is going to look really good because of direct capture on the Xbox Series X. 60 frames and everything. Like, look at this. Pretty sweet. So we're on a barge. We're arriving at Bright Falls.
It's like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Who's this old guy? Oh, he's like a troop or something. Yeah.
Damn yuppies.
Ah, he called you a yuppie. He's probably a hunter. Alright, where does she want me to stand? Where? Here? Where do you want me to stand? I don't get it. Oh, right here.
Hi. Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
It's too bright. I'm gonna lower it. Where's the brightness? I'm just gonna put it back to the default. There, that's
Deer
better.
Fest, huh?
Deer Fest.
You hear that, honey? You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Not for less than $4,000, old man.
I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Rob on Wheels is sending me $1.50 and asking, what are my opinions on the Series X D-pad, because I had some reservations initially. For the games that I've used it, I feel it's good. The thing is, I don't really feel like I've used it that much. There hasn't been a game that controlled with the D-pad that I've played. Usually it's just like switching between a menu or an inventory item or something like that. I think really the test would be if there's a game where you absolutely need to use the D-pad for motion, or maybe if eventually I play a fighting game on here and I try this as the D-pad, maybe then, but it hasn't really happened yet. It's passable for now. Nothing bad, nothing good. It's just kind of, you know, it works. So hopefully no power outages this playthrough, says Derek. Yes, that's true. And Bright Falls, Washington is where Alan Wake takes place. This is supposed to be in Washington State. That's correct. I now live in the state where this game takes place. That's right. And it's true, Washington State does have beautiful places just like this. Mountainous regions, evergreen trees everywhere. Our state is very beautiful in that regard. I'm very happy to be living here for that kind of stuff. All right.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right.
Uh-oh.
Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer?
Oh, boy.
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and
yes.
I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone out.
I already threw an old man off the barge.
Fine.
Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
I love you too.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
So the cutscenes are better, but it seems like outside of the cutscenes, the actual, it doesn't look very good. Like, the syncing of them talking doesn't look very good, right? Although, admittedly, the graphics
Come
are much
on,
better
Slow
now.
Poke. You get the full service here. I've made all the arrangements. I drive the car. I'll even carry the bags. All you have to do is drag your cute butt into the car and enjoy the ride.
Yeah, sounds like you've got a lazy bastard for a husband.
These little touches where you're...
Yeah, but I got a thing for
you. I'm stuck.
Come on, you lazy bastard. Let's go.
These little touches where, like, everything has words on it. See, like, the license plate says Washington. The sign says authorized personnel only. Like, everything is detailed nicely. Not like back, you know, 11 years ago, it was hard to get those kind of details in games. Now it seems like it's fully detailed. All right, time to leave the ferry.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
Bright Diner.
I'll pick her up or you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Now, the thing is, when I originally played this game, people said there were references in this game to Twin Peaks.
Go on. I'll promise to behave.
At the time, I had never seen Twin Peaks. It was years later, after playing Alan Wake, I watched the series Twin Peaks, so I wonder if I'll get the references.
Like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan.
Oh, great.
I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
This is like all the time, everywhere I go, people are just like, you Phil? Dark Side Phil? You're the guy? That's the guy! Oh, I'm your biggest fan! This happens all the time with me.
Rose,
I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Oh, of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
Oh my God.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Alan Wake, The Sudden Stop. The international bestseller.
Try the coffee.
Right.
Just don't blame me when
so
you fall in love.
Because
it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
What's funny is, so take a look. That is...
I wasn't ready to leave. I needed to find Carl Stuckey to get the key to the cabin.
That's Max Payne. And the name of the actor, I believe, is Sam Lake. He's the same guy who played Max Payne. It's the same company that made Max Payne. And he plays Alan Wake in this game. He's the main character.
I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
Alan! No, you can't say Alan Wake. You gotta say, Alan! Alan Wake! You cannot say it normally.
I get off work at 6.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut number 6.
Coconut? Is that the Lime and the Coconut song?
I do it myself, but... Both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Look at these guys.
Serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It's cool the locals acting so silly. Where's the, there was a thermos I just saw
you
here. There it is.
I'm in the coconut. Drink them both.
Yeah, here we go.
Just because we're brothers.
So here comes some licensed music. Oh, they're brothers. They're brothers. Remember that. By the way, take a look.
Yes,
that might be a picture of them on the wall right there. Who knows?
Tune. Coconut.
Oh, my God.
Shut your mouth, you demented has-been. If I had my hammer, I'd shut it for you. Jeez.
Derek says there's going to be Easter eggs in this game. Death Rally, Max Payne, and Deadly Premonition all have Easter eggs in the
Tune
game. That's neat.
Six in the
okay.
Box. Children of the Elder God. Now there's a song for you.
Ah, a reference. You'll understand that reference later, by the way. Children of the Elder God. All right, should we do it? Now here's the thing. I already said this as we started this playthrough. I'll say it again. This game has licensed music in it. I feel it adds to the game playthrough. Likely these videos will end up getting flagged on YouTube and Content ID match. If you like this playthrough, please support it in another way than relying on ad revenue, because chances are if you see ads on this video, it's not my ad, it's this guy's ad right here.
does that gets stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack. Now that's what I'm talking about, yes!
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Coconut. Put the lime in the coconut, you drink it all up. Lime in the coconut, you drink it all up. In the coconut, you call me in the morning. Doctor, to relieve this bellyache, you put the lime in the coconut.
Uh-oh. What's going on here?
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache.
Okay.
Overeaker fans always did.
Locked.
Doctor, to relieve the bellyache that's in the darkness, there's a demon gonna river about your heart. He's gonna eat it nice and bloody, and then he's gonna fart.
Wait, what?
Hello?
Hello, Stucky. You stuck in there shitting? Stucky, you got a Stucky poop? You need to un-Stucky? You need me to go get some X-Lax? Oh, shit.
Carl didn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
The hell? Das Boje says, I actually found the band Poets of the Fall through this game. They're excellent. Yeah, the music of the game is really good. Totally not creepy woman Aldrin that Lake dressed like a widow, by the way.
Very inspiring.
You know, most people dress like that when someone died. This is just her, like, her Sunday outing clothes. All right. Thanks. Take the back door. Nope. Weirdo.
I am so happy this could be arranged.
Oh, yeah, me too.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed. And then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
The line in the coconut.
What the? He fell asleep.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Splendid, splendid. Damn hernia.
Hernia?
Like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than it.
Oh.
It's been a long time. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you.
I wish.
Yikes. I don't even know about the size of his hernia.
The Andersons. They're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Calvin Lake Lodge.
Huh, they're not supposed to be here. They're supposed to be at a clinic. Woo-woo! The hell's that noise? Ah!
I'll
it's your
be
wife.
Heading back to work as soon as Dr. Hartman gets here, Rose. Oh, but I'm not looking forward to the poison we have at the Park Cafe.
All right. So that's our first impressions of the Bright Diner. I believe we'll be back later.
Coffee should taste.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Oh, you just saying talking about the coffee. I think that might have been a reference, but I missed it. Darn.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Oh, we'll need those. I'm fairly certain we'll be needing those.
Hey, Wake! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
It's Stucky. That's really Stucky. So wait, the real Stucky just came out of the bathroom. What the hell? So what keys did he get?
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my
my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
Damn, writer, serious writer's block.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
More licensed music. Dun, 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 dun. Okay. Diver's Isle.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry.
So,
I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness.
Hold on.
To make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
I'm going to put this to the left, and the reason being, if you haven't noticed, Alan seems to almost always be on the right-hand side of the screen in things like this, the cutscenes. So rather than block Alan's face constantly, I think I'll just move my webcam over and not block him, okay? But isn't it funny? So he was supposed to stay somewhere in town. That Stucky guy had the keys and the information about where he was staying. But the Stucky guy, for some reason, had a stomach problem and was stuck in the bathroom. And a mysterious woman shows up and tells him, oh no, well, Stucky's not here. Here's keys and here's instructions on how to get to where you're staying at a cabin. Then, as they're driving away, Stucky runs out to the street and says, oh, wait, you know, you left without your keys and your instructions. So, who's that woman? And why did she fool them into coming to this cabin, which obviously isn't really where they're supposed to be staying, right? So, it's a creepy beginning. I'm just curious, is there anything up here? Because they let you walk all the way back, but I'm just curious, is anything hidden up here? I seriously doubt we're going to get all 100 thermoses, but here's one right here, look. I came up here and I got a hidden thermos. Focus, left thumb stick.
The cabin obviously got its name from the shape of the island. It looked like a giant bird leg. Alice had mentioned that the lake was a caldera. There was a dormant volcano under it.
Oh, that's just great. I love being under a volcano when I'm on vacation. Of course. I agree. These new graphics look pretty good, man. Well, you obviously can't go this way. This is how they used to do it in games. Nice barrier so you can't backtrack. What does their license plate say? Nothing. It just says Washington, but it doesn't actually say anything. It's probably just a rental car. Oh, yeah, many movie references. Derek says there's a ton of movie references in the game. Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, The Birds, Deliverance, Shining, Lord of the Rings, Poltergeist, Vertigo. Wow. So if we can recognize any of those references. I can't run right now. The left bumper doesn't really do anything. I probably because this is considered more of a cutscene than an action scene. Swagger says he wants even bigger subtitles, so I'm going to go maximum. I'm going to just have the subtitles be 80% of the screen. Perfect. And by the way, this is the well from the ring, so the girl from the ring will be coming out. What's her name? Samara? She'll be coming out of here later. We'll have to fight her, shoot her with the gun. The flare gun to the face, light her hair on fire. Alright, here we go. Oh shit. I didn't even see that crow there. It actually startled me. Alright. Another crow. Nice music. Hello. Hello, crows. A family of crows. Nothing wrong with that. You know what they call a family of crows? A murder. A murder of crows. The Bird Leg Cabin. I thought they said it was called the Diver's Cabin. Or Diver's Island. There's a basement. A creepy basement full of zombies. Or deadites. You know, it could be a freaking evil dead. There's some deadites down there. Shout out to Nate the Great for a $10 super chat. Thank you, Nate. That is the... A generous super chat. I appreciate the support. Nice animation there, by the way. Thank you, Nate. La 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 la. Shall I search around the cabin? What do we have? Some wood? Looks like there's a shed over there. It's a nice little view out to the lake. Wow, wow. That's cool. Seeing the reflection of the mountains on the lake is actually pretty cool. again, you know, the graphics have all been overhauled here majorly from the original game. Nice. It's probably not hard to find places that look just like that in Washington State, too. Let's hope they do an Alan Wake 2, says Guts. Actually, funny you say that. The strong rumor is that Remedy is making Alan Wake 2 because just about a year or two ago, they got back the rights to Alan Wake completely. And now they can do whatever they want with the franchise, which is why for Control, there was an entire Alan Wake DLC. So chances are they probably are making a sequel. Because there's no other reason they would have wanted to get the rights back. Ah, focus.
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
Oh, you know what? Look, I can actually alternate which shoulder I'm staring at. For now, I guess I'll leave it on the right. It doesn't really matter. It's a right thumbstick. I guess I'll keep it on the right for now, but I could change it back if I want. Actually, you know what? Isn't it just naturally more on the left? Doesn't more games have it on the left than the right? Right? It always seems that way. So let's just move the webcam back now that I know that I could change it. I don't remember if you could actually change it in the original game, but there we go. Perhaps that was a quality of life improvement. I don't know, but I like that. So I'll keep them on the left. What a view. And beautiful, again, beautiful, relaxing music. What I recommend for cleaning headphones, says Froggy the Kid. I use, like, just disinfectant wipes. Or you can use, like, a spray cleaner, but don't spray the phones. You have to spray, like, a paper towel and wipe it with the paper towel that's damp. That's what I recommend. Wow. Well, look at this view. Oh, my God. Pretty nice. Let's jump up here. Carefully walk down here. Anything down there? I don't think so. Awesome. I'd like to go fishing on a lake like this. Relaxing. Right? It's nice. Pretty beautiful fresh air. It smells great. Like, oh, it feels so good to breathe that kind of fresh air. So it's funny, we will, later on, I'm sure, as the game progresses and when we beat it, we'll talk about ideas of an Alan Wake sequel. Oh, there's the basement. You know there's creepy shit in that basement. You don't want to know how many bodies are down there. There's a radio on the other side. I wonder if you can go interact with that radio now. Or if it's a dead end. Nah, it looks like right now you can't. Perhaps, maybe you can go out the back door. The game is long. If I remember correctly, it wasn't overly long. I think it's like 15 hours. If you take your time and you explore, it's probably long. And you know me. I'm an asshole. I look everywhere. I read all the logs and shit.
Let's take a look inside.
Let's take a look around. Oh, shit.
Come on.
Had to mash.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Sure thing. I'm on it.
Oh, you're a little close to the camera. The cameraman's, like, in his face. Look. What the fuck? Like, nice place to get the camera right here. Okay.